Hello and welcome to the SANFL IGA League Final Series. My name's Zach Milbank and joining me today is Sturt Captain Michael Coad. Cody, thanks for joining us.
No problem at all, Zach.
Must be really excited about the opportunity to play in the qualifying final here at Adelaide Oval under lights on Saturday night.
Yeah, definitely. The whole club's buzzing at the moment. It should be a really good night.
Certainly will for the Sturt Footy Club. Obviously, you've come a long way, particularly the last couple of seasons. Must mean a lot to the group to know that you've made it, but now you really want to create some damage that you're here.
Everyone's really happy. We set a goal to play finals at the start of the year, and we've done that, so we're excited about that, but hopefully we can do a little bit of damage.
Tough gig against Nord, obviously, in the qualifying final straight up for you. They're aiming to go for three in a row.
Nord, I don't think there's much tougher opposition at the moment, so they're really coming good at the right time of the year, so should be a good test for us.
How do you go about beating the Mighty Legs?
I think it's all... they're so good at so many things, but I think really contested footy is a big one. Big one. They probably beat us in last game, and I think we got them in that in the first game of the year, so I think start there and then hope for the best.
And another thing that they may have a bit of an edge over you guys in is finals experience, probably, because they've been here for the last couple of years, whereas you guys haven't. How do you try and overcome that?
I don't think you can really overcome the experience, but I think what we have got is a lot of young blokes that are really excited, so I think we'll bank on that.
And obviously yourself, though, you've played plenty of finals footy in the double blue. What sort of a message do you give to the rest of the playing group as your role as skipper?
I think it's just another game of footy, really, so just go out there and play the team role and, hopefully you'll get the job done.
Hope to have Corey Beard and Johnny Hinge back in defence this week for you.
Hopefully. They both trained last night, so they have a bit of a longer run tonight, and hopefully they'll both be back.
Because they'll help you a lot, particularly in battling those big Nord key forwards that ran themselves into some good form against Adelaide on the weekend.
Yeah, they did. They've got three big guys up there, which is a bit different to how they've shaped up over the last couple of years, but they've got some big guys and some really quick guys at ground level as well. So,
Zane Kirkwood's had an outstanding year, hasn't he? But he's certainly found some attention from Taggers towards the latter part of the year. Do you, as a role in terms of your team, do you try and break things up for him a little bit, give him a bit of protection?
Yeah, we always speak about that, but I think he spent a little bit more time forward on the weekend, and I think even Blinger got the tag in the second half. So, if a few more blokes step up and take a bit of heat off Zane, I think that'll really work well for us.
Looking forward to seeing Blinger, Richie Tambling strut his stuff on the Adelaide Oval turf on Saturday night. He'll be certainly one to watch. What about your role, Cody? Obviously very flexible in that you can pretty much play everywhere on the ground, even pinch hit in the ruck if need be. But where do you expect to line up in the big one?
I think I've mainly been playing up forward this year, so I'd be expected to line up there, I'd say.
And forming a nice tandem with Matty Doldig, he's in some good form in the latter part of the year, isn't he?
Yeah, Diggers played last 5-6 weeks. He's been on fire, so hopefully he gets the best defender and I'll just take the second one.
Oh, good luck with that, Cody. Congratulations on making the final series. We wish you all the best in the qualifying final on Saturday from 4:40 p.m.
Cheers, Zach.